So today we'll talk about one last type of important solid-state phase transformation, which we call Martensite transformation. It's specifically in the beginning for only one type of material, but people find it later, the similar type of phenomena is occurring not only in the iron-carbon system, but in also in other systems. But all these people call the Martensite phase transformation, okay? So, Martensite transformation, the first thing people observed them is in the iron-carbon system. Iron-carbon system, okay? Or sometimes people call it iron cementite, Fe3C, iron cementite system, okay? So now on the right side, we have a part of a phase diagram, binary phase diagram. Sometimes we call it a pseudo-binary phase diagram. On the left side, it's almost a pure, or pure what? Fe, iron. On the right side, we have, if you read, cementite, which is iron-3C. Okay, so this is a type of so-called pseudo binary phase diagram, because on the right side is not really pure carbon, which is iron-3C, pseudo binary phase diagram. But anyway, okay, and let's just stare at this phase diagram a little bit. This is, as we mentioned before, the most important phase diagram that mankind ever studied. This is, again, the most important phase diagram that mankind ever studied, because all the important structural material based on steel are essentially based on this phase diagram. And you think, well, people use steel or iron almost everywhere. Almost everywhere. Remember, earlier we mentioned that the annual production of steel is iron and steel is almost 2 billion tons. 2 billion tons, which means 2,000 million tons. And all the other metal combined, aluminum, copper, titanium, all the nickel, all those other metal combined, people are producing probably less than 50 million tons. One side is 2,000 million tons, one is 50 million tons. You see the difference between iron and steel versus all the other metals combined. For automobile, the majority are made of steel, right? For bridges, the construction material for bridges or for buildings, anyone using aluminum? Very little, very, very little, or negligible. Anyone using titanium? Completely negligible, right? So that's the fundamental reason is, okay, it's just everywhere. That's why people study this material so broadly. People use iron and steel for almost everything. For knife, anyone seen aluminum knife? No. Titanium knife? No. What knife? Steel, typically steel, maybe add some little bit element, stainless steel, but steel. And then for any of the tool, you go to Home Depot, all those tools, anyone making aluminum tool? No. Titanium tool? No. Why? One for cost, one for mechanical property. They're not any better than steel tool. Okay? And any of the saw or tool steel material, any of the saw, any aluminum saw blade? No. Why? Too soft. Any titanium saw? No, all of them are essentially steel-based. From very soft steel, pure iron that people use for tongue twister, the pipe cleaner, or for the types of material that goes into your typical tin can. Actually, people call it tin can, but actually it's almost a pure iron, not tin. Okay, very soft iron to the very hard blade, the tool steel, all those are made of iron. Okay, your construction, all the building, the reframe, the nails, all the nails, all the screws. Anyone see aluminum screw? Why? Too soft. It's just too soft. Okay, it doesn't. You screw it a few times, you quickly lose the bite. Just for all these reasons, people can just, by playing with the material composition, people can make the iron on one hand very, very soft, for pipe cleaner, which you can bend back and forth, or for the very hard knife, right? For knife, saw blade, all those type of special, for gear, surface. Anyone see aluminum gear? Quickly it would wear. Even if you make it quickly, it's expensive, and even if you make it quickly, wear off. People always make steel, some type of steel gear, right? So for all these reasons that people can change the carbon concentration, change adding a little bit of alloy element, people can make the steel almost a broad change in property and use it very widely. So we are looking at the phase diagram, very important. Again, it's the most important phase diagram. Again, at higher temperature, we have what phase? Liquid, right? Which means uniform liquid above this so-called liquidus line. And then near the pure iron side, at close to 1500 degrees C, we have the melting point for almost the pure iron. Okay, and then we have a few phases, a single phase and two phase region. One is this so-called, we label on C, is actually so-called the delta phase. Okay, high temperature BCC iron. And then we have a wide region which people call austenite, right? Austenite, that is the so-called FCC iron, the iron atom arranged as a face-centered cubic structure, okay? And then a little bit lower, we have the so-called ferrite alpha iron, which is BCC iron. And on the other side, we have the cementite, which is essentially a, we call it a line compound. Very little deviation in the composition. It's so-called a line compound, cementite, iron 3C. Okay, and then between single phase and between two single phase region, there are always two phase region. For example, between liquid and austenite, between liquid on the top and austenite or gamma phase on the left, we have two phase region, right? And also between liquid, and the lime, which is our cementite, we also have the iron 3C plus liquid. That's also a two-phase region. Similarly, a little bit lower between austenite gamma and that in the line Fe3, we have the two-phase region. Okay, of course, people give it a different name, but essentially it's gamma plus cementite. Okay, and then if we keep going down the temperature between gamma and alpha, we have this two-phase region. Between gamma and alpha, we have this one would be the two-phase region of gamma plus alpha, right? And then, of course, if we keep lowering down the temperature, at here where I'm pointing, which is on one side, left side is alpha, on the right side is cementite, okay? On the left side is alpha, on the right side is cementite. In between from here all the way to here, from left all the way to right, as long as temperature is low, we have two-phase region. Essentially what? Alpha plus iron 3C. That's a two-phase region, okay? Of course, in this phase diagram, a little bit complex, people call it perlite and some other name, but essentially all those are all still alpha plus cementite, which is iron 3 carbon. So for such a system, if we look at a specific composition that, okay, as we illustrated in this blue arrow, we're cooling from what? Austenite, gamma phase, single phase, into the two-phase region. Okay, into the two-phase region. Okay, under equilibrium condition, what should happen? If we cool it very, very slowly, we would get a two-phase. One phase is alpha on the left. The other phase would be the cementite, Fe3C, on the right. But what people find is, if people do this quickly, like an iron smith, he would put his red hot iron deep into oil or sometimes even water. People find with extremely rapid cooling and people find the extremely rapid transformation. Rapid transformation of the high temperature phase, the gamma phase, austenite, into the fine hard structure. What type of structure? It's actually people call it alpha ion, alpha prime. It's like a BCC, similar but not exact. People call it a martensite without significant eutectoid transformation, which is it doesn't really go through the equilibrium reaction from gamma to alpha plus IN3C cementite under fast cooling. These type of phenomena, people call it martensite transformation. Okay, and what we are going to talk about is it's a transformation into a so-called metastable. Metastable means it's not exactly the alpha prime or the martensite. The alpha prime or the martensite is not the most stable phase under that condition. It's not the lowest energy state. But because we are doing this in a fast or slow process, fast, actually very, very fast process, it ends up in this so-called metastable state. This is a martensite transformation. And if we want to talk about a little more, this martensite phase would have, read, carbon supersaturation. This so-called alpha prime phase, it's a single phase, but the carbon is oversaturated, which means the carbon concentration within this alpha prime is higher than it actually can handle, but it just froze in there without coming out as either cementite or graphite. Okay, the general definition for these type of transformation, we give it here, a solid state transformation with no change in composition, going from one composition to the same composition, but there's a sudden change in structure, crystal structure, but structural change due to short distance coordinated movement of atoms. So no composition change. So do we need a long range diffusion? No, because it's the same composition. I don't need a long range diffusion. It's short distance, read the highlighted sentence, coordinated motion. The atoms are moving kind of in a highly coordinated, like a military, in the same direction, march for the coordinated, let me not say the same distance, but coordinated distance, so that, okay, you go from one pattern to the other pattern in a very short period of time.